John Payne here with ZTPMAG in Louisville, Kentucky for the Louder Than Life Fest. I'm standing here with Scott Frazier, manager of Volbeat, second time around managing Flaw and one of the men responsible for bringing this wonderful festival to Louisville. How you doing, Scott?
I'm doing great, man. Thanks for having me on the camera, man. This is a pretty cool thing. Welcome to Louisville. Look how beautiful this place is. Can't see it on camera, but it's awesome.
Yeah, in fact, we were just talking about that. You could have done this show other places, but you chose this. Why is that?
Well, let me first and foremost say that, although I'm a small part of this festival, it was my idea to bring it here, but I can't take all the credit. Danny Wimmer and his whole crew are the ones that really put this thing together with Rock on the Range, you know, orchestrating that, and their other successful festivals, Carolina Rebellion, Aftershock, etc. So my role is small, but important nonetheless. So
Louisville, you have Scott Frazier to thank for your bringing it to Louisville, at least. We're outside Arlene's Grocery in New York for another band that Scott used to manage, Bobaflex, and we're sitting in the van, and Scott goes, check this band out, man. He throws on Warrior's Call, and I was blown away. Everybody was blown away. So my question to you, Scott, what is it about Volbeat that made you go, this is the one, these are the guys I'm bringing to America, and we're going to do this?
You know, it's funny, it's really a cool story. The band obviously was very successful overseas and doing really, really well abroad. At the time, we were also managing Saving Abel, had the same booking agent, and the agent sent us a really cool video. It was actually the Johnny Cash cover that the band does, and I immediately called my business partner who manages the band with me, Rick Smith, and I said, dude, you need to check this out and watch this like right now. So we both were like getting each other just super, super excited. And next thing you know, we had a couple meetings with the band. They were out with Metallica at the time. And we met them in Grand Rapids, had a really, really wonderful meeting with them. Then we kind of played the waiting game because I know they were talking to a lot of other potential suitors. And the vibe between the two of us just really clicked. And the rest is history. A lot of people told us we were crazy. A lot of people said that, who's going to bring a band here from Denmark and have success in America? Well, you were wrong.
Definitely we were wrong. Many metalheads across this country or rock fans are very happy that you brought Volbeat to America.
Rock is dead.
Being the manager of several successful rock bands, in fact, one of the most popular rock bands right now and still going strong, what are your thoughts on people saying rock is dead?
Well, I don't think rock has ever been dead, nor I don't think it's been threatened. I mean, we've all been in this game long enough to know that music comes around in cycles. And if you notice, for a period of time, there'll be the more commercial sounding bands, the Saving Abels, the Nickelbacks, et cetera. And then all of a sudden, the more aggro bands start coming around, and they because people just get tired of that, they want to rock. So I don't think it's ever died. But I will say this, shitty music is dead. That's all I'm gonna say. Metal and rock is well and alive.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
You want to? Is there any new bands that you're working with? Any kind of new exciting things going on with your management group?
We just picked up Rev Theory. I think everybody knows those guys. So their new single just came out, Born to Destroy, hashtag B2D. Check it out.
Born to destroy!
A band from Mississippi called Roscoe Bandana. A really cool band. Nothing like these bands, but a great band nonetheless. They're a cross between, like, if Lady Antebellum and Bob Dylan had a kid, you would have Roscoe Bandana. So make sure you check that out.
Did you hear that? Roscoe Bandana. Check it out. It's always been a pleasure seeing you, and thanks again for the interview. And
my pleasure.
Take it easy from Louder Than Life Festival 2014.